Before we get started with the first period, I'd like to thank the Rensselaer Union. They provide the funding for WRPI and all the club-related activity of the Institute, including WRPI's coverage of RPI hockey, football, and baseball. Just a reminder, WRPI is on the World Wide Web. Point your browser to WRPI.org, and you can pick up WRPI's broadcast 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. As long as WRPI is broadcasting, we provide that broadcast on our internet feed. Once again, it's WRPI.org. WRPI Sports seeking current students make live calls of athletic events such as this one. There are opportunities this season to be on the air for men's and women's hockey and for baseball. To inquire, please drop us a line at wrpi-sports@rpi.edu.
Getting ready for this one, Tom. Obviously, all these games big coming down the stretch. Both of these teams playing pretty good hockey right now. The Engineers laid a bit of an egg, in fact, a goose egg against Yale on Saturday, looking to come back home where they have been successful.
Yeah, they certainly need to prove a lot to themselves after last weekend, because bear in mind that on Friday they also kind of got bailed out a little bit. Brown took a very commanding 3-0 lead in the second period. Engineers were able to bounce back from that one, in part because Brown kind of let their foot off the gas a little bit. They played a Yale team on Saturday, which they got down 3-0, and Yale was not ready to let up there. They put in a command performance and did very well in that one. St. Lawrence has some questions as well. You know, they just got off of a long schneid last weekend at home by sweeping Cornell and Colgate. But those are a couple of teams whose fortunes have taken a certain a dip to them. Colgate's not nearly as good as everyone has expected that they were going to be, at least in the standings are concerned. And Cornell seems to be a team in absolute free fall right now. So St. Lawrence has a little bit to prove here tonight as well. And as mentioned during the pregame, we've got two of the best goaltenders in the league and really in the country, Kyle Hayton and Jason Kasdorf here tonight. So St. Lawrence is still a team that can get points from anywhere on their forward lineup. So if they can prove to themselves and prove to the league that they're back, this is going to be a really tough game for the Engineers.
Absolutely. RPI in their home white, black and red trim. St. Lawrence in red with black and white. Red helmets on both sides of the ice tonight. As we're set to drop the puck at the Houston Fieldhouse, we are underway. And it's Nolan Glukowski dumping it in off the stick of Kasdorf, high off the glass into the near corner. Zach Schrader looking to dig it out of there. The senior from Prior Lake, Minnesota, has it stolen away by Joe Sullivan, top scorer, one of the top two point getters for the St. Lawrence team, as it's going to be dumped in by Sullivan, who's forced all the way out to center ice by the Engineers. RPI breakout. It's sophomore Mike Pravovesis who falls down on the play but gets back up and puts it out to center. Gavin Bayreuther, the other top point man, 17 on the season, gets it stolen away. Easy stop on the try by Zach Schrader from just inside the line. Will be held onto by Hayton.
Kind of expect this is going to be a game that's going to be similar to the Mayor's Cup for RPI, and that in order to get one past Kyle Hayton, they're going to have to get a good bounce. They're going to have to get a rebound. Kyle Hayton doesn't get off a lot of rebounds, but they saw a goaltender just like that Saturday night, and now it's Lyon. They're going to need to get a little bit more than they were able to get last weekend.
Here is Wilson. Jared Wilson off the boards. He took a hit. Miloš Babela down low, the senior from Banská Bystrica, Slovakia. Now it's Jake Wood with a shot from the half wall wide. It caroms all the way out of the zone, trying to move it out to center ice. And it's Wilson throwing his weight around once again. He laid into Jacob Pritchard there, forcing Bayreuther and the Saints back to their own end. Cross ice feed, trying to find Gisowitz as they move it towards center all the way down the ice. And that will be icing on St. Lawrence here, although that group just on. We're just 1:05 in, no score. RPI, the 14th ranked Engineers, and St. Lawrence.
RPI already with a little more jump in their step than they had to start last weekend off in both of their games. That was one of the things that got them behind both Friday and Saturday against Yale and Brown, was that they had poor starts. But we're very early in this one, but there's already a little more pep to their step.
Face off in the St. Lawrence zone, one back behind the goal for Gavin Bayreuther. The junior has been a top offensive threat since he joined college hockey ranks a couple seasons ago. It was a hit behind the RPI goal. Tommy Grant has his man pinned off the puck. No one knows where it is. Losing his stick in front is Wilson. Liljeren tried to kick it to him, and then it's botched at the line by the Saints. Ben Masella lost the handle, but right back into the zone they come. As another steal there, stolen away this time by Jesper Orval, the freshman who was red hot in December. Cooled off slightly in January. He's still having a solid year with 11 points so far. Back to their own zone are the Saints here. Working it up the wall is Masella. And carrying into the RPI zone is Laidley. Played behind the cage. It's swatted at there by Phil Hampton to the wall. Mears Moore trying to get it out, couldn't do so. Wrap it around to the far point where it's kept in. Tipped just wide a goal by the man in front. That was Laidley again, a freshman from Little Current, Ontario. And the Engineers now take over. Hampton, cross-ice pass near side. Here's Gillespie into the zone. Gillespie pulls it back and drops it off for Riley Bourbonnais. Bourbonnais behind the cage. Wrap around, fed in front off the skate of Fulton. Coming in, Bradley, a drive. That hit his shin pad. Kept in, Prabaves is at the blue line. He skates to the near point. Gillespie down low, on for Bourbonnais, shielding his man off the puck. That was Sweetman, still Bourbonnais, wrapped up by Sweetman, and has worked out to the far side, bouncing puck towards center. Mike Marnell can't control, but is carried on further by the Saints. Ryan Law into the RPI zone, trying to jam it home. Law denied by Kasdorf on the short side. Now Marnell turning and throwing it out the back of the net. It's picked up by the RPI captain, senior Chris Bradley. Bradley off the boards, can't clear. Second effort from Gillespie, no. Right back to Bradley. They still can't get it out. Saints keep it in near point. Here's Bayreuther. Has some room. He'll hold it and fire a shot. Saved by Kasdorf. Can't swat it out of there. Second effort does. Right back to Bayreuther, the near point. He's being hounded there by Melanson. Now Melanson tries to break the pass by him. He'll beat out the icing and pick up the puck behind the goal. Tied up now, it's Gisowitz and Melanson. Puck back to center on the outlet pass. Christian Horn spins away from the check of Grant, but lost the puck in the process, and the Engineers regather at center. Fired ahead for Schrader to tap it in. Lively boards off the back wall, tied up there is Schrader and his man Gisowitz. And it's going to be Schrader once more on the cycle. Pass Nanny to the far corner. 3.5 minutes into the first period, no score, shots are 2-2. Wrist shot coming, blocker saved by Hayton to the near point. And that one skips by Wilson all the way out to center. Tommy Grant over to play, worked it back out to center, where Sullivan will spin it right back into RPI territory. Picked up by Wilson, up the wall. Didn't get as far as Melanson, but the Engineers do get it deep. Controlled now by the Saints out of their own zone. Masella far side, good connection. Tommy Thompson to the RPI zone along the half boards. He takes a hit from Hampton, separated from the puck there. Mears Moore has a chance to look up ice near circle. Moore back across for Hampton. Plenty of room for him, right back to Mears Moore. They play catch into the St. Lawrence zone. Moore lost the handle on the puck, took his eye off it. A shot back out to center by the Saints. Bouncing puck into the RPI bench. We get a stoppage. 15:39 on the clock, first period, no score.
Starting lineup for RPI tonight, pretty similar to what it's been in the recent past. The only really major difference is that Riley Bourbonnais, the junior out of Rochester, New York, back in the lineup for the Engineers. He's got 20 points on the season. That's good for a tie for first with sophomore Lou Nanny.
Center ice draw, flipped off the wall by Moore, controlled there by Sweetman. Eric Sweetman, assistant captain from Woodbine, Maryland. Can't clear the zone, picked off by Miller. A shot by Wood and a pad save made by Kyle Hayton, who's had to be in top form early on. The Engineers have thrown a couple at him now. Four shots for the Engineers. To center, collision there. Wood knocked his man down. Miller picked it off. Hampton for Babella. Into the zone comes Miller, just onside. No, he wasn't. And we get a whistle. With that whistle, Tom, we get a chance to tell you about the oddity that happened before today's game with the officials.
Well, the original officiating crew that was supposed to be here is now actually in Schenectady, because this officiating crew that was supposed to be in Schenectady is here because they got caught up in the snowstorm going on in New England. So the officiating crew has changed for tonight. Whitmore and Lynch, the referees, and Petey and Noeth, the linesman.
The more you knoweth.
The more you know it.
Bradley cross-ice feed for Prapavassis into the zone. Here's Liljegren. Fed towards the goal. Steered to the corner by Hayton. Here is Jesper Orval. Spinning a couple times. Flips it neatly to the far corner for DeVito. Gives it right back to him behind the net. Orval off the back of the net to himself. Swept to the far side where Prapavassis pinches in. Orval jumps on a loose puck there. Center blue line for Bradley. Wrist shot coming. Hit a skate and went wide. That was DeVito trying to provide a screen. It might have hit him in the end. As they pair off in the near corner, Liljegren trying to kick at it. He's got his head wrapped around the head, or his arm wrapped around the head of Laidley. As it's finally worked back out, Bradley, a shot coming. Rebound tap to the corner again. Hayton is seeing these shots, and the Engineers could use a little more in front of him as the puck bounces over to Orval at the far wall. Chipped out to center ice, Prapavesis takes over again. The amount of shots coming has to be a bright spot so far. Shot by DeVito, well wide of the goal. It'll rattle all the way out of the zone and picked up by Tommy Grant in his own end. Cross ice near side for Jared Wilson. Leads all RPI defensemen with 4 goals. This one in on goal from center ice as Hayton leaves it at the side of the cage. They give it away there. Gillespie had it pop off his stick and out to center. Fulton near side for Bourbonnais tries to chip in. He gets run into by Masella. Taken over by the Saints behind the cage is Law. Far side. Marnell up the wall. on further by Alexander Dahl. It'll be wrapped around to the near side half wall. Masella bouncing puck for Long. And Masella keeps it in at the line. To the far point now, wrist shot coming, goes wide, looking for a deflection, didn't get it. It'll be Masella again at the near point. Turning with it there is Mike Marnell, playing in just his 17th game, 10 points on 6 goals and 4 assists. Now Gillespie fans on it, that allows Marnell to jump on the puck. He'll play it back behind for Wilson as Wilson takes over. Jam tried the side of the cage, picked up by Wilson again, as that was Tommy Thompson trying to sneak a cheap one in there. Loose puck in the middle of the RPI zone. Fulton clears it near side for Wilson. Wilson to center, carrying it on by himself. He'll flip it into the corners. The engineers want to complete a change. 12:43 left in the first period. A scoreless game between the 14th-ranked engineers and the Saints of St. Lawrence University. Into the zone, Tommy Thompson battling there with Melanson. They go hard into the back wall. Melanson takes the worst of the fall as it's picked up by Moore. Off the wall for Schrader. Far side pass for Hampton. Hampton into the RPI, into the St. Lawrence zone, will carry into the corner. Still Hampton, centering pass, hopped over the stick of Nanny, who had set him up nicely in the slot there. But that pass just eluded him just a bit, and he wasn't able to make contact with the puck. It'll be picked up in the far corner and cleared by Eric Sweetman. All the way down the ice, a race for the puck. Prapovesis is all tied up there with Christian Horn. Played up the boards. Gisowitz near side, slap shot coming off the glove of Kasdorf on the try by Bayreuther. Around to the half boards, poked at by Nanny all the way down the ice. It'll be corralled there at center by Smolzinski. Drew Smolzinski, far side into the RPI zone. Drop pass, top of the circle, feeding it in front. Smolzinski a try, fed right through the top of the crease, and it came all the way loose to Bayreuther. He'll pull it back to the top of the circle, shot. Rebound pops out in front, and Babella will clear it out center ice for Miller, who couldn't control the pass. Bayreuther right back to it for Smolzinski. Into the slot, another drop pass. To the far circle they go. Drop it back again. Bayreuther a shot. Plenty of bodies in front, and they break it up. Now Babella skates back the other way. Milos Babella on the stick handle. Lost it on the blue line on a poke check by Masella. And it's shot into the St. Lawrence bench, and we get a stoppage in play. 11:16 on the clock.
St. Lawrence has recovered well from their early tribulations in the attacking zone, where they really weren't taking very good care of the puck and allowing the engineers an easy time on defense. But the last couple of sequences in the attacking zone have been very good for the Saints. They've come very close, really within a whisker of scoring these last couple of minutes. The RPI looks like they've got their game plan down as well. They want to try and put bodies in front of the net and get redirections in front of Kyle Heaton.
Face off here in the neutral zone, one back. It'll be Masella, nearly gets hit by Liljegren, kind of missed it. Now Lidley, he'll clear to center ice. Glove down there by Jared Wilson. That popped off the forechecker, McGovern, and taken over again by Wilson. On for Liljegren, who shoots it deep. Masella tapped it along, intercepted by Wilson, and his shot from the top of the circle is turned away by the right pad of Hayton. To the near side corner, it's McGovern. It's underneath some bodies, and we get a whistle here.
Well, the engineers are certainly making Kyle Heaton work for his living here tonight. That's already RPI's 8th shot on goal in this game. Shots are 8-3 in favor of the engineers. That's something we haven't seen from RPI in quite a while. This game isn't even 10 minutes old, and they're already approaching the double-digit mark. That's got to be a good sign if you're an RPI fan.
Face-off here in the St. Lawrence zone. We're about halfway through the first period. That's Liljegren driving to the net, trying to jump on a loose puck. DeVito gave a whack to his man behind the net. That was Glukowski. But it is the Saints who move it out to center. Got lost in some snow in front of the Saints bench already as it's flipped in deep into RPI territory. Here's Marnell wrapping it all the way around, but his pass left the zone. Just lost the handle at the last second. Center ice play now into the zone. Comes Sweetman. That one shot wide to the near side corner. Glukowski keeps it in. Down low. Dahl. Wrapped up by Wilson. And now Schrader comes away with it for the engineers, are moving out far side. Neutral ice crossing the red line and shooting it in. Zach Schrader. Wrap it around to the near side corner. Glukowski trying to clear. Now play it back behind for Sweetman. Outlet pass connects there for Dahl, and now back to Sweetman. Sweetman pressured a bit by Phil Hampton, is a bit out of position. He'll head back to his own blue line. Sweetman now through center ice, connecting there. Nice job to stay onside by Sullivan, or did he? No, he nearly did the splits to hold the line, but the linesman on the to our right said no.
That was a bit of an oddity. I was looking down and said, oh, RPI's got someone on the forecheck. That's Phil Hampton. Don't expect any defenseman ever on the forecheck, but he was able to basically push St. Lawrence a little bit back farther into the zone and allow the RPI defense to get set up for that last drive.
Here's Bayreuther up the far side wall. Horn all the way down the ice. This should be icing on the Saints, and it is. We'll have a stoppage here. 9:32 on the clock. Engineers with an 8-3 shot at, edge in shots right now, Tom.
And a lot of it's really just being, I won't say opportunistic. They're not waiting for good shots. They're just taking shots when they think they've got a screen or where they have an opportunity for a redirection. And a lot of them are just getting through on Kyle Dean.
Bayreuther back behind the cage. And up the wall, that was Gisowitz. Through everybody. This will be icing again. It's a little bit disjointed right now, this Saints breakout. A couple passes have missed. A couple people pointing fingers here, but we'll see how they react to another straight icing call.
Of course, RPI needs to take advantage of these here by winning faceoffs in the attacking zone. That's been one of the key elements they need to improve in their game, is winning faceoffs.
Another defensive zone win for the Saints here. Bayreuther for Sullivan. Joe Sullivan through center ice. I mentioned the top point getter. 9 goals, 8 assists. His 9 goals lead the team. This is a team like RPI that gets its scoring from a bunch of different players. Outside of Riley Bourbonnais for RPI, it was 13 goals. The drop-off is pretty considerable. Here's Melanson trying to stick handle through the circle. It's stolen away. Carried out far side to center. And it'll be Tommy Thompson to shoot it in for the Saints. Tommy Grant behind the RPI goal. Good forecheck for a second there. Thought he was going to steal it away. That was Jacob Pritchard, but the engineers do regather. Sent right back to the Saints at their own line. Tipped towards the RPI blue line. Is broken up by Prapovesis. Now carried in. Into the far circle. Shot was blocked by the boot of Grant. Gillespie shoots it high off the glass, and this will leave the zone. Bouncing puck. Gillespie could turn into a 2-on-2 as it was Sweeman just off the bench, and he laid into Gillespie there. And now Holt gets upended along the far side. Well, we play on. Glukowski behind, and we're going to get a hand pass called behind the Saints goal. Faceoff coming in Slew territory.
Some of the names to be on the lookout for the St. Lawrence Saints. Joe Sullivan, the sophomore out of Las Vegas, Nevada, the leading scorer for these Saints. He has 17 points. That's 9 goals and 8 assists. And then Mike Marnell, sophomore out of South Huntington, New York. He was the top returning scorer from the team last year with 6 goals, 4 assists on the season so far this year.
Kukowski far side, good connection there. Brian Ward, the captain, into the RPI zone. He's upended in the circle, swiping at it. Hampton, still trying to gather the puck. And finally, it'll pop to Gillespie, who shoots it off the wall to center. Picked up there by Eric Sweetman, who fires it back in. Sweetman, another prolific defenseman on the attack. 3 goals, 10 assists for 13 points for him so far this year. Puck bounced off Sweetman, fanned on by Gillespie, picked up by Hampton. He'll work it up the wall. Poked away from him, loose in the center ice circle. Gutkowski plays it right back to the line. Into the zone, McGovern. Stick handles by Hampton to the far side. Drop pass by Hagen, and they give it away. Gillespie to center, on for Babella. Has some speed into the attacking zone. Babella, tight angle shot, saved by Hayton, and he will not allow a rebound.
Well, that's one thing that Kyle Hayton's very good at, is making sure that puck stays right there within him, especially when you're shooting it right at him. Babella didn't have much of an angle on that shot, so Hayton able to just stick with it. Get the whistle with 7:26 left in the first period. No score on RPI in St. Lawrence.
Draw coming far side of the St. Lawrence zone. One back again by the Saints. Bayreuther up the glass, past everybody. Played by Tommy Grant, who shoots it right back into Saints territory. Bayreuther once more. Shot all the way down. They wave off the icing. Say it was tipped. Kasdorf didn't think so, but it's played by Babella. Around to the far half wall. Here's Jake Wood, fanned on the initial pass, gets a second chance, and finds Babella, who chips it all the way in. Race for the puck, first one to it's going to be Miller. The Messina, New York native, playing against his hometown team. St. Lawrence here, he has 11 points against North Country teams in his career for the senior. Rung in by Miller, behind everybody, picked up by Bayreuther, and he'll work it out far side. Flipped in the air, Bradley can't glove it down. After a little bit of a hop, it's played to the corner. Prapovesis is around behind for Milos Babella. He has some pressure there from Sullivan, but works it off neatly for Bradley. The center ice for Miller. Up the wall, stolen away by Sweetman. Here comes Sullivan for the Saints. Into the zone far side, takes a hit from Bradley, but gets it deep. Tommy Thompson takes a whack. Puck comes free to the near corner. Prapovesis has lost it. Carried on further by Thompson. Thompson, handoff for Sweetman. Nice move by Horn to get free. Blocker saved by Kasdorf into the corner. Not sure how he saw that one, but he got that right-hand blocker up to make the stop. Flipped out to center ice, too far for Liljegren. Turned right back around by St. Lawrence. Here's Sullivan. On for Horn. Horn pulls it back. Tight angle shot save. Rebound. Thompson's tied up. And Lildren will come pick up the mess as he'll skate out with it here. Near side for Bradley. Chris Bradley to center. On for DeVito. And that was stolen away by Lildren. Although he lost the puck. Still loose in the circle. Now here is Orval. Orval stick handling back to the point. He'll ring it in for his countryman Lildren. He can't control. Played to the far side now for DeVito. On for Orval. Playing from his knees, flipping it near side, and now the Saints can break 4-on-2. Here they come, far side into the zone. Pritchard, drop pass, saved by Kasdorf on the drive. It was the fourth man into the zone that took the shot. That being Matt Permal. And that was turned away by Kasdorf. He saw it well. Bayreuther at the point. Wrist shot coming, save. Kasdorf, rebound loose just outside the crease. And it's flipped to the far side. First one to it. Permal couldn't keep it alive in the zone. As it's moved out to center by Orval. Back to the engineer's end. Quickly ahead for DeVito, one-on-one with Glukowski. DeVito spinning around in the corner as his teammates change behind him. DeVito looks to cycle. First one to it will be Laidley. And it's played behind the goal for Eric Sweetman. Sweetman in the air to center. Schrader tried to glove it down. And then he dumps his man in front of him. That was Alex Hagen, who tried to sneak off with the puck. Schrader wasn't having it. Here's Mears Moore. The freshman from Duluth, Minnesota, far side for Phil Hampton. A little bit of pressure comes, plays it off the glass into Saints territory. It's punched out to center by Sweetman. We get a hand pass here on the Saints defenseman. Shots are 9-6 engineers with just 4:25 left in the scoreless first period.
St. Lawrence probably with the best chance of either team to score in this game a couple minutes ago as Christian Horn, the senior out of Plymouth, Minnesota, made a nice little toe drag to get around his defender, put a shot through to a screen Kasdorf. Perry, I'm with you. I'm not sure exactly how he saw it, but he was able to get his blocker up and put it aside.
Played behind the Saints zone. Engineers putting on some forecheck pressure. Somehow, Glukowski, who Houdini's his way out of there, has played to the near side wall. To center ice. Sweetman's tied up by Melanson. Onto the tape of Schrader, but he's knocked off the puck. Back to Bradley in his own zone. Prapovesis spinning around at his own blue line. He'll work it up the wall for Nanny. Chips it off the linesman's skate. Right to Melanson. Drop past Nanny. Near side Bradley. Walking in Bradley. A shot. Saved by Hayton. Loose puck is covered. And now Melanson's going to get some attention after he went after Hayton's glove there. That's all that comes of that.
Some quick reflexes by Hayton. He wasn't sure exactly where the puck bounced to, but it bounced basically right below him. And it took him about a split second for him to look over and just drop his glove on it. When you were looking to your side first and you still are able to cover it up before anyone can get to it, that's some mighty quick reflexes.
That's, you need to be a top goaltender. Both of these netminders have that. You don't expect a high-scoring game, although we say that just about every time they meet. And last time it was 4-3 in overtime up in Canton. Here comes Dahl into the RPI zone, carries it across dangerously. Drop pass there. Glukowski wrist shot, caroms off the back wall. Pinching in. Bayreuther stick handles around Fulton. Bayreuther on it behind the RPI cage. Fulton trying to stay on him there, gives him a whack up on the shoulder. Now a shot coming, stopped by Kasdorf. A little bit of a change up there from Dahl. Kasdorf read it and did squeeze it before the Saints could pounce on it.
I feel very confident saying we haven't seen a rebound off of a shot that either goaltender saw clearly. That was another example right there. St. Lawrence needs to get a little more in front screening Jason Kasdorf if they're going to get anything off of that, because Kasdorf just a little bit too good in bringing that one into his body.
Faceoff win for the engineers into the near corner. That one skips by Thompson. Miller trying to work it out to center. This may be icing on the engineers. As it comes in on Hayton, the engineers may have dodged a bit of a bullet there as it's back out towards center. Sullivan overtaken by Babella. Threw it off the skate of Thompson. And now played back to the St. Lawrence line. Turning with it there is Matt Permal. Shoots it in wide of the RPI goal. Kasdorf behind the net to play it. He'll throw it off the glass near side. Sullivan can't control. Played behind by the engineers once more. It is Wood. Back for Tommy Grant, the engineer's freshman. He's been a pleasant surprise for them this year. On the blue line, has a couple goals already. Yeah, playing in just his 19th game as the engineers do ice the puck here with 2:39 left in the first.
And Jake Wood lifted his stick right as the puck was coming to him. I think he meant to flip it into the zone, but instead he didn't touch it at all. Ended up being icing on the engineers with 2:39 remaining in the first period. No score in this one. Shots are 11-7. Favorite of RPI, so RPI's shooting has cooled off a little bit here in the last 8 minutes or so.
Draw to the right of Kasdorf, one back to the point. Sweetman Glukowski near point. Wrist shot hit a skate. Picked up in the slot by Prapovacic. Throws it far side. Wood can't find it. He finally does. Throws a shoulder into Ward and clears the puck down. This will not have the legs for icing. Glukowski back behind his own goal. Leaves it there in the corner for Sweetman. Eric Sweetman. Far side. Moves into the neutral zone. Connects to the line. But Smolzinski took a step over the line. That's just a bit of casual play there from the junior from Hatfield, PA, Drew Smolzinski.
This combination on defense for St. Lawrence can be dangerous scoring as well. We saw Eric Sweetman here last year in Troy score a couple of goals for the Saints. His tag team partner is Nolan Klukowski, and between them they have a combined 25 points on the season. That's pretty solid for a defensive pairing.
Liljegren off the offensive zone faceoff win. Couldn't control the puck. The Engineers are forced back out to center. Here's Mears Moore crossing over the red line. He'll fire it in. Wrap it around to the far side wall. Liljegren stops it there. Has a man behind the net. It's DeVito. Trying to find him, but intercepting it was Glukowski. He'll work it far side for Smolzinski. Smolzinski carries through center. Stick handling and flipping it backhand into the near corner. Mears Moore will try and track it down ahead of Brian Ward. Ward gets there. Fed back to the point. Bayreuther pulls it back. Takes a wrist shot. That hits some legs in front. Never got to Kasdorf. Flipped in front again. Loose at the side of the cage. And Kasdorf had that left leg pinned against the post. There's some loose sticks on the ice. At least one. That was Moore as he goes back to pick it up. The Engineers try to clear, and they do get it as far as center ice. And then a big of a high hit there. The fans don't like it. By Gisowitz. It's moved on by Liljegren. Trying to step through a check of Bayreuther. He goes down with Marnell, taken away by Orval. Work it to the near point. Shoots it deep. Schrader, he battles there with Gisowitz. And Gisowitz works the near side for Laidley. Melanson at the near point, now just off the bench. Keeps it in for Schrader. Along the boards for Lou Nanny. 14 assists on the season for Lou Nanny. Leads the team. He's tied with Bourbonnais with 20 points on the season as they tie up in the far corner of the St. Lawrence zone. Schrader. Flipping it towards the top of the circle. Schrader takes it away and works it down low for Melanson. Melanson gathers a hot bouncing puck and spins away from Gisowitz. Melanson once more has a man at the point. It's Bradley. He rips one high over the top, bounces off the back of the net, and is carried on further by Prapovacic. Prapovacic cycling for Melanson. 37 seconds to go in the first. Fed to the near point. Shot by Prapovacic through everybody. Poked out to center. Race for the puck. Prapovacic is going to win that race easily as the Saints want to change. Prapovacic is up the wall on for Schrader. And now Nanny. Cross ice feed. Didn't get it deep. Marnell wants to turn with it quickly. Mike Marnell into the RPI zone far side. Stops up at the half boards. Now to the point. Trying to work it down low, but Bradley's the only one there. He'll wrap it around to the near side wall. Bourbonnais trying to clear. Can't get it by Glukowski. Now Marnell, a tight angle shot there from the below the dot. And Kasdorf made the save. And now it's carried up to center with 4 seconds. Shot in from center ice. Easy stop there on the try by Gillespie. And then shoulder-to-shoulder collision between the Bayreuther, or excuse me, a Sweetman and Gillespie as the period ends. Our shots here at the Fieldhouse say 12-9 Engineers. Scoreless first period. How many times have we said that this year, Tom? A lot of games have gone scoreless, one, sometimes two periods into the game, especially here at the Houston Fieldhouse.
Well, for RPI, the key right now is faceoffs. They've got to be a lot better on faceoffs. There were 17 faceoffs in the first period, and RPI won 4 of them. That's really stark. We haven't seen anything that bad since, 2 weeks ago against Union, where they were basically losing every faceoff in the third period. It's been a point of emphasis, and they've, you know, it's just something they got to get better at. They have to win draws in order to possess the puck. It's really that simple. They lose opportunities to shoot the puck and score goals when they're not winning faceoffs.
Yeah, absolutely, Tom. We have ECAC Hockey does a weekly podcast, and they do a great job with it. They had Lou Nanny on this week. We'll have that interview for you during our first intermission. Once again, your score after one is RPI nothing and the Saints of St. Lawrence nothing. You're listening to live coverage of RPI Hockey on 91.5 FM, WRPI Troy.
If you want to stop by the Engineers Pro Shop, located across the concession stand, living in section 2. They're fitted hats, fine glass, game gloves, t-shirts, and more. Stop by and check out all of you.
Didn't look good from my eyes, and the numbers reflect that 13-4 Saints.
Yeah, that wasn't good at all. But if you're a St. Lawrence fan, I'm sure that was splendid. So there is the flip side.
Engineers skating from left to right, the Saints from right to left. I apologize to the family of RJ Gusevich and for horribly butchering his last name. I will never do it again. Shot in by the Saints, played around by Joe Sullivan. Centering pass, Dahl tried to flip it. Backhand style out in front, tip just wide of the goal in front again. That was Dahl after the shot came from the point by Glukowski. And now losing his stick on the play was Krapovesis. Got tangled up under Horn, and now it's driven right to the net. Tap to the corner. Horn all the way through to the far side. Glukowski nearly lost his balance there. Stays on the puck, flips it back to Sweetman, who played it off his skate to his stick. He's being hounded by Melanson. Still Sweetman along the far wall, fed across. Glukowski had his pass intercepted by a teammate. And now Glukowski, a shot saved. Kasdorf, rebound loose. Kasdorf has his feet pinned against the post, and he finally covers. Great awareness and good calmness there by the senior net runner. He didn't know where the puck was. He was able to get in position and still keep it up.
That was truly impressive. He was pretty much down on the ice. He had his feet against the post, as you said, and then the puck came right to him. And he ended up smothering it with his glove, like while he was basically on his stomach. It came right towards him, and he grabbed it with his glove. That's impressive.
Jason Kasdorf here for the Engineers makes his 12th stop, so a quick 3-0 lead in shots for the Saints. Centering pass right in front. Kasdorf, another point-blank save, and this time on Ward. And the fans here give their appreciation. Maybe not as much as they should. That was spectacular.
It really was. And Brian Ward, the senior out of Haverhill, Massachusetts, I think he thought he had his 8th goal of the season right there. He was absolutely stone-robbed by Jason Kasdorf on that shot. So shots on goal here early in the period are 4-0 Saints.
Kept in again by the Saints. Gusevich along the wall. Now a centering pass, sliding block made by DeVito. To the far side, now Bayreuther. He pulled it all the way down low. Now he spins back towards the half wall. DeVito is battling there with Pritchard. Engineers haven't left their own zone since this period started. Gusevich along the near side wall. Shot was blocked by Prapovesis. And now moved out to center. Gusevich shoots it right back in. Now DeVito. And that one offside whistle. As the Saints needed a touch up when that puck left the zone, they did not.
RPI just got to start winning some faceoffs here. I mean, they're basically free possessions for St. Lawrence. One of the reasons why it's been down in the RPI end the entire time is that RPI still has not won a faceoff here in the second period.
Center ice draw, flip to the RPI zone. Mears more cross ice for Hampton. Up along the boards and into Saints territory. Shot by Fulton, looking for that far pad, got it, but it didn't find a teammate. That's what Fulton was trying to do, create that rebound off of Hayton's pad for a teammate. Just didn't find him there. And the puck back down into Engineers territory. Hampton, long stretch pass all the way down the ice. It caroms off the backboard, played behind by Hayton. Bourbonnais beat the race to negate the icing, and now we have to track down a puck at center. Wilson shoots it in from center ice, gloved easily by Hayton. Now he wants to cover. He was going to leave it for a teammate, but Gillespie and Bourbonnais came flying in, changed that decision. Even in shots, 13-13, we're just a little over 2 minutes into the second, no score.
Yeah, that certainly was some good strategy there by Fulton. I mean, RPI is of the impression that Kyle Hayton's going to stop the first shot, and you kind of have to. But if you can force him to make a save, just having him kick it aside, that's what's going to lead to some rebound opportunities, and RPI was unlucky not to have someone on the other end of Fulton's shot there.
Face-off win, Grant Arister. That one's blocked. Loose puck in the slot. A couple Engineers take whacks at it, but more or less catch shin pads of Saints players as it's played back into RPI territory. Tommy Grant does a nice job to muscle Dahl off the puck, and now it's taken over by Babella. On for Wilson, who chips it into St. Lawrence territory. Bringing around to the near side corner. Wood takes a look over his shoulder. Lost the puck for a second, but it pops right to Babella. He throws one towards goal. It goes through the crease. But the net part of the crease was defended by the netminder Hayton. In the corner now, far side of the Saints zone. Miller trying to pry the puck free. He continues to do battle there with Sweetman. Got his arms up high on Sweetman, but nothing illegal about that. Worked out to center. Here come the Saints. Law into the RPI zone. Pulls it back. Takes a wrister looking for the far post. And he missed it by about a foot and a half. Chopped out of the zone by the Engineers. Will it have the legs for icing? My guess is no, it doesn't. Back to pick it up is Gusevich. He'll play it up the far boards. Kicked at by Schrader, but it pops right to Tommy Thompson. Thompson around the net. All the way around. Turning and shooting one. It goes through the crease. Picked up in the far circle. Here is Bayreuther. Bayreuther now carries to the near side corner. Bayreuther all the way back to the near point. He'll wrist one goal. Tip just wide in front. It was Sullivan who redirected it, and it went just wide. Now pinching up the boards far side. It's Gusevich. Back to the point for Sullivan. Has some room. Wrist shot coming. That one hit bodies in front. It's picked up by Melanson, and he'll chip out to center to relieve the pressure. Race for the puck. Nanny showing his wheels, and he nearly stole it away. Now he does from Sullivan. Lou Nanny in the corner. Cycling down low. Melanson off the back of the net. He was trying to find Schrader. Off the near side board, Schrader picks it off, fed across, poked away by Sullivan. Right back to Schrader, it hopped over his stick, and back out to center come the Saints. Into the RPI zone is Horn. He takes a hit and lost the puck as line mates change behind him. Hampton up the near side wall, tipped into the zone by Liljegren. Back to pick it up, it's Masella for St. Lawrence. 15:48 left in the second period. Tipped to the RPI line, they're offside. Pritchard can't touch it. Smartly does not, but the engineers have time now to take over. Phil Hampton lost the handle on it for a bit, but gets it over to Moore. Far side of the RPI zone, now back near side for Hampton, who's played all 28 games for the Engineers, the senior from Oakville, Ontario. Engineers get it in deep. Played around behind to the near side corner. Chopped at by Orval. Again by DeVito. It's controlled along the boards and moved out by Smolzinski. To center ice, Engineers play catch at their own line. It's Grant flipping it far side, knocked out there neatly by Orval. And now saucer to the middle of the ice for Liljegren. Liljegren walking in. He couldn't get the shot away. Liljegren back on it to the near point for Grant. Grant holding, wristing, tip on goal by DeVito. Easy stick stop as the play by DeVito slowed most of the momentum out of the puck. Took the heat out of it. And it was an easy stop in the end for Hayton. Now Tommy Grant drop past Fulton. Back down low for Grant. Grant, backhander in front. Loose puck tipped to the corner. Grant again will backhand it down low, as his adventure to the offensive end appears to be over for now. 14:44 left in the second. A no scores. It's played to the RPI line. Bradley throws a phantom hit. The man went down, Hagen, although I don't think Bradley hit him at all. Back into the zone come the Saints. Stick handling there, knocked away from McGovern, pops right to Hagen. Hagen tackled by Fulton as the puck is played in deep. Now Hagen once more as a man in front finds him off the crossbar. McGovern had a chance in front and he just glanced it off the top of the net. Now back out to center come the Engineers, glove down by Gillespie. He keeps on trucking into the zone. Shot goes way wide. Picked up by Fulton at the point. He'll play it right back down low. Wrap it around to the near side corner. It's Bayreuther. Or make it Sweetman rather. Kept in the zone by Fulton. Glukowski wraps it around far side. Going to be kept in the zone by Bradley. Down low, here's Bourbonnais right in front trying to find Gillespie. That one skips by Babella out of the zone. And did he touch it? They'll say yes, no icing here. Played by Kasdorf in the corner. Back to Babella, he'll slow things down behind the RPI cage. We are scoreless here. Both of these teams have played in scoreless ties this season. As it's shot in by Milos Babella, RPI's coming here at the Houston Fieldhouse against Harvard in early December. Played along, and now the Saints have a chance to break into the zone. It's Mike Marnell. Pulls it back, takes the shot. Kasdorf, glove save. He never went down. He made the glove stop and holds on to it there.
Well, RPI comes into tonight's contest alone in third place in the ECAC. They're a point behind Harvard in second, and they're a point ahead of Yale in fourth. And just taking a look at the scoreboard right now, both those teams have leads. Harvard up 2-0 over Brown, and Yale up 4-1 over Dartmouth in the second period. So RPI may need a good result here in order just to keep pace in the ECAC.
One back to the point, Saints have it, offensive zone shot coming, clean off the far post. Picked up there, trying to walk it out is Horn, all the way around to the near side half wall. Horn still with it, center blue line, shot coming over the top. Karams with a far side circle, Babella off the backboard, near side for Wilson. He'll control it there, has a man breaking, it's Wood. Trying to find him, he can't, all the way down, this will be icing. Ah, the Engineers, and Wood can't believe it. Although Bayreuther was not on the same side of the ice as what he did win the race to the dots. And I think the argument is that Wood was going to get to the puck first. They should have waved that one off.
Yeah, they're going to have this one at center ice. Seth Apper was apoplectic. Jake Wood was upset. You can hear the entire RPI crowd seemed to dislike that call. And I think it probably should have been waved off. They were on either end of the net, as you mentioned, Perry. And on a tie in a situation like that where there's no risk of a collision, that should have been waved off. So the faceoff at center ice instead.
Center ice draw here. The St. Lawrence tie came against Quinnipiac 0-0 November 21st of 2015. As it's chipped into the zone, fortuitous bounce for the Saints and a backhand shot easy saved by Kasdorf in the end. Brian Ward had that puck pop right to him as it was flying into the zone. And his backhand shot was easily held, however.
But once again, RPI loses a faceoff. This one, fortunate for them, though, was at center ice and not in the attacking zone. Gives St. Lawrence an opportunity to score.
Face-off moves to the wall. Ward works it back towards the point. It was broken up for a second by Melanson. Second effort picked up Schrader, and he'll carry through center. Schrader fed far side. Offside is Melanson. As that puck hit his skate on his way to him, Melanson slams the boards with his stick, but there's not much he could do about that there.
Yep, sometimes your momentum's just going to bring you into the zone, and if the puck takes a bounce, you're pretty much caught out in no man's land, and Melanson had to drag his stick back across the blue line to pick up that puck. So just a bad luck for the Engineers, but they're going to have another faceoff to have to contend with right outside of their attacking zone.
Draw here, neutral ice, far side. And it's played to the near wall, knocked out of the air by Tommy Thompson and controlled by the Engineers in their own end. Here's Liljegren. In deep. Still Liljegren being harassed there as a stick up under his arm continues to move the puck to the far point with it. Bradley waiting, pulls it back, wrist shot, Hayton didn't hold it. Rebound DeVito, save again by Hayton, and he covers this one up.
It's the right idea. You get those rebounds and take that second shot quickly. Just didn't quite have the execution there for the Engineers to get it past one of the top netminders in the nation, sophomore Kyle Hayton. So instead of the faceoff in the St. Lawrence zone, which St. Lawrence will gladly take.
Jimmy DeVito gets tossed from the dot. It'll be McGovern against Liljegren. Victor Liljegren wins the faceoff. Back for Bradley. Tight angle shot played off the backboards by Hayton. And now here is Alex Hagen for St. Lawrence, the senior from Bronxville, New York. Works up the far side boards. Into the zone they come lately. Prapavesis shielding McGovern from the puck. It pops to the near side boards. DeVito trying to work it out. And he does in the air, past Sweetman and all the way down the ice. Sweetman will control it in his own zone. Pulling it away from Orval. Orval gives him a whack. Puck to center, played by Gillespie. Can't find Fulton. Sweetman jumps right back on it. Now it's swept away in the end by Prapavesis and moved to center by Wilson. Glukowski right back into RPI territory. Mike Prapavesis back to pick it up. The sophomore from Oakville, Ontario, leads all RPI defensemen with 13 points on the year, along with 11 assists, which is tied for second on the club. Played around far side, or third rather. Into the zone, or neutral zone, come the Saints. It's Law, he shoots it in. Dahl behind the net, beats Grant to the puck. Gillespie tried to run into Marnell, missed him. Marnell picks it up on the far half boards. Pushed over by Fulton, jumps right back on it. Marnell in front, one-time shot, saved by Kasdorf. Rebound loose, where is it? It's underneath bodies as Kasdorf made a save to his right and then left that left leg along the ice to make a second stop, and he covers it up there. Kasdorf having to make more of the saves here in the second than Hayton did in the first.
That's a little change up there by Marnell, who I think in most cases you expect the puck that comes loose like that to be blasted, but it was more of just a tapped opportunity that he was looking to cross up Kasdorf on.
Clearing effort came off a body, so there won't be any risk of icing. It wasn't shot down anyway. Beg your pardon, shot in again by the Saints. Picked up by Wilson. Jared Wilson will slow things down once again here on the breakout for RPI. Shots are 19-17 Engineers. But the Saints have seemingly had the better of the chances here in this period. Here's Bumella moving it around behind the goal. Took a hit but stays on the puck. Nice one-hand carry by him. Down low for Orval. Knocked away from a second by Masella as Wood comes to help out. Wood scoops it between his own legs. That's going to be a hand pass. Saw it from up here and they saw it down there. That'll draw a whistle.
Yeah, there are five officials in red that saw that one too. That called that one just before the whistle blew. So face-off coming up at center ice with 10:19 left. And this one, still no score between RPI and St. Lawrence. No score, no penalties. Shots on goal are 19-17 in favor of RPI.
Face-off at center ice. The Engineers get it into the zone. Prapavesis with it along the wall. He'll cycle for Schrader. Zach Schrader with it. Gets run into there, pinned against the boards by Thompson. And that'll allow the Saints to move it out to center. Christian Horn, the senior from Plymouth, Minnesota, has it stolen away. Flipped high in the air by Melanson. Will it find the bench? No. Right in front of the bench area. Played by Sweetman up the wall. Intercepted by Schrader. Schrader on for Melanson, who taps it into the corner. Glukowski and Melanson go into the wall. Melanson comes away with it. Drew Melanson fed to the far point, but Bradley just couldn't get there. Bradley a little more central than Melanson thought he was. Prapavesis back to his own end for Bradley. Then he undercuts his man. Played to center, tipped into the zone by Melanson. Sullivan slow to get up as he was undercut by Prapavesis. Played back to the point, but there's nobody home. The Engineers were changing defensemen. Here's Joe Sullivan now from Las Vegas, Nevada, playing it down low. Tommy Thompson in the near corner. Carries it all the way out back towards the point. He's being harassed by Grant. Broken up there. Nanny, a backhand pass, was behind the intended target. Had a man breaking. It was Orval. Back come the Saints. Bayreuther, a shot. That goes wide. As you are listening to live coverage of RPI Hockey, 91.5 FM, WRPI Troy. Mike Laidley has it stolen away by Schrader. On for Liljegren. He feeds it far side for Wilson. Wilson leading the attack into the offensive zone. Still Wilson. Backhand pass. Right out in front. Rebound put wide by Liljegren. To the far side circle it goes. Saints player lost his stick. Is going to draw a penalty. That was Gusevich. It's touched by the engineers. And we're going to leave a slashing call on RPI with 8:46 left in the second. The first power play for either team comes here.
I think some people would complain about that one being called when so much gets left undone. But that's been the case here in the ECAC the last two or three weeks. Has been not an awful lot of penalties being called, but they're going to call stuff that's relatively dangerous, and that was a dangerous slash by Liljegren. So we're going to see St. Lawrence go to the power play for the first time tonight.
St. Lawrence power play 12.8% on the year. The engineer's penalty kill at 84.8. 84 out of 99. This is the 100th penalty, or penalty kill chance, I should say. Not one and the same against the engineers this year. Smolzinski works it to the wall for Horn. Back to Smolzinski. They get closer and closer together. It makes it tougher for Horn to make a play. He does, however, work it free. Loose puck to the half wall. There's a man breaking. It's Miller. Can they find him? No! Wood for it just behind Miller, who would have been off to the races shorthanded. As the engineers do have six shorties this year, half of them belonging to senior Milos Bobella. But Miller nearly had a chance for one there. 1:16 left in the St. Lawrence power play as they work it through center. Drop pass on the center ice logo, poked away by Bobella, forcing another faceoff here at center. Good defensive stick from Milos.
Really aggressive penalty killing by RPI. We haven't had to see their penalty kill since last Friday against Brown, and it wasn't particularly strong against the Bears, as they were 0-for-2 on the, 0-for-1 on the kill that night, but an opportunity here, and they're doing very well.
Shot into the RPI bench by Phil Hampton, who's got a bit of a smirk on his face. Hit a couple teammates in there. They looked like they were paying attention, but we do have a faceoff in the RPI zone, so really, engineers have to regroup quickly here. There is Phil Hampton, if you're watching on the feed. If you're not, then you have no idea what I'm talking about. Here's Glukowski, near side for Hagen. Hagen back up top for Glukowski. Wrist shot coming. Easy glove stop for Kasdorf. And he holds on.
It's one thing to have a solid goaltender, but it's another thing to have a solid goaltender who's going to make a save as calm as the one as Jason Kasdorf just made while killing a penalty. He just kind of stood in there, watched it come to him, and snapped it up to his glove for the whistle.
Puck poked away by Nanny, trying to skate off with it himself. Avoids a hip check from Sweetman. Into the zone, Nanny stops there. Fed in front for DeVito. Loose puck, still trying to find it. And it's Glukowski who will skate back behind the net as the engineers back off. But Nanny and DeVito getting a round of applause here from the home crowd. Expecting close to 3,300 tonight and a sellout already, I believe, since Tuesday for the freakout tomorrow. 47-16 is the official max here. And Troy.
A couple of really nice moves by Lou Nanny, shorthanded. He got around his defender at the blue line as the defenseman tried to throw a hip check and then quickly spun around to his backhand trying to get a shot off, and DeVito came in crashing. Really a golden opportunity for what has been a very aggressive penalty kill for RPI.
Draw here at center ice, played back by Miller. Kasdorf stops it up for Wilson. He'll shoot it off the glass and down the ice. It's broken up in center, however. Second effort by Schrader gets it into St. Lawrence territory. Still 18 seconds left on the power play. Shot in from center and well wide of the net. It's played there by Ward. Back to the point. Glukowski over to Bayreuther. Bayreuther holding. Fed to the slot. Backhand pass far side. Up from the skates for a second. And now Glukowski once more. On for Bayreuther. To the circle, a shot. That one's blocked by Wilson. Out of the box, Liljegren, and we're back to five aside. Saints still on the attack, however. Poke free. Loose in the circle, and now here is Liljegren moving it out to center ice. The sophomore from Stockholm, Sweden, pushes it around Glukowski. All the way to the goal line, he's taken down. Fans unhappy with it. Looked like he may have lost an edge on the play. Smolzinski lost the puck, but it's back for Bayreuther. Around the net for Glukowski, as Liljegren gets a little bit of redemption, throwing his body into Bayreuther on a tip, just by the net by Bayreuther. It's been fun by Bourbonnais, and Bayreuther nearly put it into his own net. It's back out to center for Bradley. Bradley crossing center, dumps it in. Gavin Bayreuther can't control the puck there. There are two engineers in the middle. Brett Passes has it off his stick. And now a chance for the Saints to break, but they can't find the outlet man. And Law has it knocked away. Back down low it goes for Bradley. A couple of near breakaways here in this one. Still scoreless. Shot right on. Save. Counselor. Rebound covered by the blocker. It was Alexander Dahl planted right in the circle. His shot may have caught a piece of the mask of Kasdorf on his way through, but didn't beat the senior goalie.
Really end-to-end action here now, and a good back check by Drew Melanson as St. Lawrence with the break the other way. Just held him up long enough for the defense to get set for RPI. That's been kind of an underappreciated aspect of RPI's defense stand this year, is that their back check has been superb as well.
Face-off here in the RPI zone, puck spinning near the wall. Finally worked free, past Marnell. Wood can't get it out. Kept in the zone by the Saints. Turning with it here. Drop pass. Fanned on it by Krummel. Stayed on the blue line and stayed in the zone. That puck just sat there, allowing the Saints to keep the play alive. Now Bubella picks up the puck far side of his own zone. Stick handling to center. Gets around a couple of Saints, including Dahl. And it looked like Marnell. Shot to the near side circle. Wood backhand try. Save. Rebound loose in the slot. Bouncing puck for Bubella. And nearly pried away. Good strength by Milos to keep it in the zone. Now Miller down low for Wood. He'll hold in the corner waiting for reinforcements. In front for Miller. Intercepted nicely by Law, who can't clear the zone. Kept in by Hampton. And now it leaves to center. Gloved ahead by Marnell. Mike Marnell into the offensive zone all by himself. Men trailing to the far side circle. Bouncing puck there. Gillespie throws a hit and is loose now for Miller. Miller wants to skate. Has Gillespie with him. Miller to the net. Still Miller. Poked away at the last second there by Gusevich. And he'll work it out to center ice. Poke free by Marnell. Controlled by Hampton. There's a player down in the corner. We're going to late whistle here. And it's going to be against the engineers. They're going to get Miller. Or is that Melanson?
Melanson, yep. And that was kind of coming all along. Both teams, after the Wilsington penalty ended, started stepping up their physical play. And it was almost kind of a dare to see which team could get away with the most. There was a lot of physical play, some open ice hits, some questionable calls both ways. They end up getting Melanson for boarding. So St. Lawrence back to the power play, 0-for-1. So far tonight, and RPI's penalty kill was really aggressive the first time around. We'll see if they stick with that the second time, because it almost cost them late in that penalty kill. St. Lawrence had some golden opportunities that they weren't able to cash in on.
Face off here in the RPI zone, as Tom mentioned. St. Lawrence currently 0-for-1 on the power play. 4.5 left in the second. We are scoreless, as it's going to be Gavin Bayreuther for the Saints here. Through center, drop pass at the center ice logo. On for Smolzeski, he gets dumped by DeVito. Puck loose in front, it's played behind the cage. Here's Horn. To the point, Bayreuther. To the slot, knocked away. Lots of time for DeVito, finds a lane and shoots it all the way down. Left behind the net by sophomore Kyle Hayton out of Denver, Colorado. 13-9-2 on the year, exactly 2 goals against. Lower than that in the career. Is Hayton at 198. Now a chance shorthanded for RPI. It's Miller jumping on the puck in the circle. Slap shot coming. Hayton about 3 feet out of his net made the save. Off the crease, I should say. And made the stop. And it's regathered by the Saints. They move it back into RPI territory. Intercepted. Miller shoots it down. As Hayton again will leave it at the side of the cage. We're under a minute to go in the St. Lawrence power play. 3:25 to go in the second. No score here. Here's Glukowski shooting in from center. Caroms off the backboard, picked up by Bradley. Shot all the way down. If that engineer's got a better bounce, Bubella may have been off for his fourth shorthanded goal. As is the case, it's all the way down the ice. Hayton steers it away from Bubella. Sweetman down the middle of the ice. Into RPI territory, still Eric Sweetman. Sweetman to the far. Things up there, play it far side. Brian Ward. Fed near side in the air for Glukowski. Settles it down. Back to Ward. One-timer off the base of the net. High off of the glass. And back to the corner. Hagen. 8 seconds to go in the power play. Glukowski, center blue line. Far side. One-timer. Shoulder save. Kastor. Loose puck in front. Stolen away by Wood, who shoots it near side for Melanson. And now a chance for 3-on-1. Melanson in. Pulls it back. Takes the shot. Saved by Hayton. There's no rebound. Now Melanson gets clobbered. Hayton's in there as well.
disagree with Melanson's decision to shoot it because he's shooting on Kyle Heaton by himself with two other guys there, but that's neither here nor there. Any forward is going to crash. And I guess it wasn't actually Heaton who made the first go off. That's going to be Brian Ward going off the roughing. That's not smart on his part. Heaton kind of followed up himself, but really you got to keep your cool there. Your netminder just made a great stop. And the Saints captain's got to be a lot smarter than that down low because RPI just came off another big penalty kill. They had a real strong effort, and now we got the power play for the first time tonight. And the last time we saw the RPI power play, they were busy going 2-for-3 on the weekend last week. So that's a significant improvement from recent days.
I don't know if you're St. Lawrence, Tom, if you want Kyle Heaton getting agitated like he is. I know the goaltending position, you have to keep your cool, and we've seen even through a year and a half of his career, he is a little bit hot-headed at times, and he will mix it up like he just did. The Engineers can get under his skin, not the end of the world. I don't think Melanson did anything that would warrant the kind of aggression that was shown.
That was not a smart play by Ward in the least. He really needs, especially as a senior captain,
right.
you have to be setting a little bit of a better example for your teammates just by kind of just trying to defuse stuff instead of going in after the shooter.
Center ice draw here. Power play time for RPI. The Engineers on the season, 11 for 82. That's 13.4%. Moved in. Here is Jesper Orval along the boards. Back to the point. Prapavesis. Orval once more. Down low. That pass handcuffed Melanson. Clearing effort. Not going to get the job done. Kept in by Mears Moore. Now Orval, the near point, four forwards out there for RPI, it's Prapavesis and Moore, the two defensemen. Fabella drop pass. Far side corner, Melanson back up top for Moore. Mears Moore, near side for Prapavesis. He'll carry it back center blue line. Far point for Moore. Wrist shot coming, deflected into the netting. We'll have a stoppage here. Minute 38 left in the second, minute 18 on the RPI power play.
Engineer faithful getting a little agitated there. They wanted to see a shot, but that was some good power play time for RPI, holding the zone, forcing the St. Lawrence penalty kill to kind of become a little tenuous, and they got a shot off, just ended up out of play for the faceoff.
Draw here, one back by St. Lawrence, clearing effort, kept in by Wilson. And now he'll wrap it around behind. Gutkowski hands it off for Sweetman. He'll try the glass this time. Hampton not tall enough to keep that one in. All the way down, it's stopped by Kasdorf. A little bit of pressure from the Saints. Engineers have it here. Shot up the boards. Controlled hit linesman skate. Now moved on further by Liljegren. Liljegren fed far side. Hampton some room. Tipped in front, Danny. Loose puck there. Sweetman going to try to clear. Puck straight in the air. And now a chance for Law. Shorthanded. Now it's going to be a hand pass. That's the correct call. And we'll have a stoppage here and a faceoff back in St. Lawrence territory. I don't think they're allowed to change on that hand pass call.
Nope, they are ensuring that St. Lawrence has the same personnel out there. And it did take a couple of beats for them to make that call, but a good call. Certain hand pass helped St. Lawrence get it out of the zone. So opportunity for RPI. Once you get the faceoff, you got to win the attack.
One far side, chance to clear is Joe Sullivan on the carry. He'll chip it softly to center. He gets dumped by Bourbonnais right in front of the Saints bench, and Sullivan is down. And we're going to get a whistle here. Bourbonnais threw a hit into Joe Sullivan along the boards. He's right in front of his own bench. Not a long walk for his trainer, who's out to tend to him here. 25 seconds left on the power play. Bourbonnais now takes a whack from Ben Masella. Didn't think much of it. No penalty was called initially. And I don't think we're going to get one here.
Yeah, I don't think much of this one, although Bourbonnais did get his elbow up a little bit. I don't know if they're going to call it. I don't know if the referees saw it.
Well, I don't think they did because they didn't call it initially.
Yeah, he was a little high on that hit, and that's an area where it's a little more dangerous because it was along the St. Lawrence bench. There wasn't any glass for him to hit into. Sullivan's rather upset as he whacks his stick along the boards as he comes back to the bench. He looks like he's going to be okay, which is good to see, but he's frustrated at something, whether it's the lack of a call, being in a position to get hit, whatever it is. But
No penalty being called with 51.8 seconds left in the second period. No score in this one. RPI with 25 seconds left on their power play.
Back to action here. 48 to go in the period. Prapavesis from his own zone on the carry. On for DeVito, tipped into the zone. First one to it, Jake Wood. One hands it to the corner to himself. To the point for Bradley. Now Prapavesis holding. Up top for Bradley once more. Lost the handle on the puck and a move out to center. He's being harassed there by McGovern. Fired near side for Prapavesis, and the Engineers will restart. 25 ticks to go. Out of the box, Ward. Engineers 0 for 1 on the power play. Shot in from center. Stopped there by Hayton. He will cover as Bourbonnais comes gliding in to make sure there wasn't a transaction of the puck there.
Well, we're 20.5 seconds away from a scoreless game after two periods. Both teams have had opportunities on the power play, although I have to say that RPI's power play had better opportunities than St. Lawrence saw in their 4 minutes of man advantage.
Faceoff win for the Engineers. Trickling shot to the near corner. Nanny fed to the Babella. One-timer pass saved by Hayden. Got that left leg along the ice and made the stop. Kept in by Grant down low. 8 seconds to go in the period. Miller just dumped. Chopped out by Babella. It pops to the corner. 4 seconds. The lights go on here in the stands. We're still playing. And now we get the final horn. Plenty of action here. Babella goals after two periods. Shots of 25-21 Engineers. RPI still down 9 faceoffs, 25-16 in that department. Something they look to continue to improve on. It's just kind of tough at this point of the year to expect any kind of movement in that regard, but they can try to do some different things to win these puck battles, especially in the two big ends, the offensive-defensive ends.
Well, this is what we expected, and Harry, you mentioned at the outset that when we've expected defensive battles, a lot of times we've ended up with track meets sometimes, but here between Kyle Hayton and Jason Kasdorf, there's no daylight. Kasdorf with 21 saves and Hayton with 26 for St. Lawrence. It's got all the hallmarks of a first goal wins type of game, and heading into the third period with no score, that's pretty much exactly what to expect. Next goal will be the first goal, and the first goal should be the deciding goal, I would think. I mean, it's just there's just so little between these two teams defensively that if either of these teams could put one in, it's going to go a long way towards coming away with 2 points.
These two teams played a similar game in the second game of the tournament last year.
Second round. Yeah, it was the first game.
First
game of the second round. RPI and St. Lawrence went head to head. Jason Kasdorf had one of the greatest outings that you'll see from an RPI netminder in a loss. It reminded me a lot of the game 3 in 2004 between RPI and Dartmouth and the ECAC quarterfinals, where the two teams went pretty much blow for blow. Nathan Marsters had a tremendous performance but came out on the wrong end of a 1-0 game. This time last year,
yep,
it was St. Lawrence coming out 1-0, and the game-winning goal was scored in the final minute of regulation. That's a heartbreaker.
Yep. And they played, yeah, right. You figured the Engineers needed game one, especially the way they played, if they're going to try to upset the Saints in that series. It was a tough way to go.
They got the game they needed, but Kyle Hayton and Jason Kasdorf can be game changers by themselves. So far, that's what we're seeing here tonight.
We are 20 minutes away from the 39th annual Big Red Freakout, but still a lot to be decided here, Tom, between the Saints and Engineers. We'll take a break and be back with our second intermission. Once again, your score after two periods. RPI nothing and St. Lawrence nothing. You're listening to live coverage of RPI Hockey, 91.5 FM, WRPI Troy.
The following sponsors, Red Bull Alumni Association, then I am your host, Patterson, Sanders, Ginsburg, and Griffin Law Firm, Sodexo, Subway, The Hill Garden Inn, Macaluso Wealth Management Group, National Grid Foundation, The Recovery Sports Group, E. Stewart Jones Hacker and Murphy, Stanley Steamer, CDTA, Stewart's Shops, Rensselaer Honda, Domino's Pizza, Fryhawkers, Turner Construction, and Saratoga Eagle Sales and Services, all proud sponsors of RPI Hockey. Hey, the Moncton Mohawk Figure Skating Club has begun its 64th year of offering Learn to Skate classes right here at the Fieldhouse. Classes are for all ages. For more information, check out the program at hmfsc.org. Elsewhere in the ECAC tonight in New Haven, after two periods, it's Yale 4, Dartmouth 1. After two in Providence, Harvard 2, Brown 1. After two periods in Princeton, it's Princeton 4, Colgate 3. Late in the second period in Hampton, Connecticut, Quinnipiac 2, Cornell 1. And after two periods in Schenectady, Clarkson 2, Union 0. Fans, RPI Men's Hockey would like to welcome PAC 23 Cub Scouts from Del Mar, New York. Thanks for your support and for joining us tonight.
Back inside the Houston Fieldhouse here on the campus of Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute in Troy, New York. We get set to bring you the third period of action between the RPI Engineers and the St. Lawrence Saints. My name is Tom Rail. I am with Perilous Garris here this evening, and you're listening to your home for Engineers Hockey, 91.5 FM, WRPI Troy. While we have time, before we get started with the third period, we would like to thank the Rensselaer Union. They provide the funding for WRPI and all the club-related activity of the Institute, including WRPI's coverage of RPI hockey, football, and baseball. Just a reminder, WRPI is on the World Wide Web. Point your browser to WRPI.org. And you can pick up WRPI's broadcast 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, as long as WRPI is broadcasting. That broadcast is provided for you free of charge on our internet feed. Once again, that is WRPI.org.
20 more minutes to go here, maybe 25, as RPI and St. Lawrence playing ECAC hockey here at the Houston Fieldhouse. It's getting down to the last few weekends here, Tom. The Engineers, two games this weekend at home, and they travel to Harvard and Dartmouth and host Quinnipiac and Princeton, and then that's senior night against Princeton on the 20th. They close the regular season against Cornell, or Colgate and Cornell, on February 26th and 27th. We're underway here in period number three. Tommy Thompson shoots it in. We are five skaters assigned to begin the third. It's played around on the near side boards, lifting the stick and playing it Far side was Melanson on for Nanny. Nanny kicks it to himself, one hands it on goal. Hayton makes a save, breaking his stick in half on the play was Sweetman. He'll go pick up the pieces behind the goal.
Well, when there's no score after 40 minutes, sometimes you just throw it on there and see what works. It can be just as simple as that. Make the goaltender make the save. It's been fairly easy for both of these netminders so far in this game, but you never know when you're going to put one on there that's going to be difficult for them to handle.
Face off here, kicked at by Miller. He'll move behind the goal with it. Miller in the corner, still trying to feed it back to the point. That pass was broken up and moved out to center for the Saints, stopping at the far point there and moving it deep. Pritchard, he intercepts that play along the wall to keep it alive. Back to the point now. Kasevich, one-timer, Bayreuther. I don't know if you half fan on that one, caught the heel of the stick and didn't get anything on it. Bayreuther again, this time he catches it more cleanly, hit a skate, rebound save by Kasdorf on the try by Pritchard. So length the second, the Saints some early jump here in the third.
And really, in the first minute here, we're already seeing both teams taking just that kind of tack. Just throw it on net, see if you can get a bounce, see if you can just catch the netminder napping a little bit or just barely out of position. All it takes is a little bit of daylight. You can get that through for the first goal, and that's going to be very important.
Face off here in the RPI zone. Play behind Tommy Grant, claiming his stick was being held. Gathers it in time to play it far side. DeVito trying to kick it out from beneath him. There's a bit of a stalemate along the wall, far side of the RPI zone. We're a minute 10 into the third period. No score. 14th ranked Engineers and the Saints of St. Lawrence, who were ranked the last time these two teams met. Backhanded in front off the nub of the stick of Kasdorf. That was along the ice. Played to the point, kept in there. Gusevich's shot is blocked. And it's back out to center. Tipped along, passed to Grant. No, 2-on-1 down low. Centering pass. One time stopped by Kasdorf. And it's played by Liljegren. Kasdorf was sprawled out along the ice to make the save. And now back comes Liljegren with some speed, stopping at the hash marks far side. Liljegren swept to the near corner for Moore. Mirrors Moore around the goal. Far side, stops along the line, and he'll move it into the corner. Has Orval with him. Escapes out of there. Jam try Moore. Continues to battle along the post, and now we get a stoppage as there's a body up, pile of bodies, I should say, just inside the crease on the far side.
Put the puck as close as you can to the net and then try to shoot it. That is also a possibility, but it's worth pointing out that neither of these netminders give up very much in the way of wraparounds or jam tries from behind the net. So, optimistic, a good try, but still nothing doing for the Engineers. 18:03 left in regulation, still no score between RPI and St. Lawrence.
Saints trying to break out of the zone, but it's bottled up along the wall. Here's Fulton trying to play it back to the point. Intercepted by Hagen. He kind of threw a stick behind his body, and now back comes St. Lawrence. Lately, shot nearly caught to Kasdorf, and nearly did that shot too. Hagen, the net came off in the end. That was a hard carom off the backboard that allowed Hagen to get that try. It looked like he just missed the net. It looked like he had a lot to shoot at.
He had more to shoot at than we've seen pretty much all night, and that's just based on the way that puck came off the end boards. That's your worst nightmare as a netminder, to not know where that puck is bouncing to after a shot goes wide. It was a lucky bounce for St. Lawrence as they had plenty of opportunity to get that one in there, but just couldn't find a way to get it to settle down before taking that shot. RPI is going to call a timeout here after that one. That was maybe a near-death experience for RPI. They want to kind of settle down the defense after that. And they're going to partially take this timeout because RPI is not going to be allowed to change your line after the net came loose. It was more or less knocked off by Jason Kasdorf. It's not like he wheeled around and destroyed it or anything.
Right.
His momentum carried him into it. So it's a situation where it's more or less an icing call because the faceoff's coming up in the RPI end and the Engineers can't change. So that's what happens sometimes. The Engineers are going to burn their timeout with 17:45 left in the third period. Still no score between the Saints and the Engineers.
So we'll have a faceoff coming in the RPI zone. Couldn't quite tell from the angle that Alex Hagen had. He does have 6 goals and 6 assists on the year. Just like looking, missed the net. Maybe the puck didn't sit for him. Not 100% sure, but as we mentioned, Kasdorf was down and out of the play for all intents and purposes. Here's Krapovets off the defensive faceoff win. picked up by Nanny, shot to center, fired right back in by Glukowski. Here's Chris Bradley, behind for Prapavassis, and now on for Schrader. Zach Schrader crossing center, hit the boot of Horn, and it's cleared back out to center ice in the air, waiting for it to fall was Thompson. Engineers regather, however. Bradley on for Prapavassis. Cross-ice feed into the skates of Nanny. He'll poke at it, trying to kick at it too. Orval over there, Nanny gets it back, trying to feed it down low, couldn't quite get it there. It's played behind by Sweetman and around for Marnell. Marnell tried to drop it back for Glukowski. All the way behind the goal it goes, and now Thompson once more. Played to center ice, gloved down by Horn, takes a whack at it. Marnell helps out, shooting it into RPI territory. Grant has it again, trying to spring Nanny. Near side into the zone, slap shot coming. Blocker stopped by Hayton. Off the near glass. Miller has his man tied up. Played high into the air by Ward. Bouncing puck falls right to Grant. Near side for Bourbonnais with Babella. Babella shoots it in. Back to pick it up is Gusevich. And now he'll use the net as a screen to get away from Wood, but he nearly gave it away to Babella. Babella goes sliding hard into the boards. Nothing intentional there. He lost his balance and went careening into one of the Saints players. That was Ward. Back comes Bayreuther. Shoulder save on the shot by Bayreuther by Kasdorf. And now it's played back out to center. RJ Gusevich through center ice right onto the tape of Wilson, who plays it ahead for Babella. Good poke check there by Bayreuther to knock it free. Bouncing puck far side, onside to Smolzinski. Wrist shot! That one missed high and wide. Caroms all the way out of the zone and all the way down the ice. Rarely picked up by Ben Masella, the junior from Montreal. Masella, a goal and 7 assists on the season. Far side for his defensive partner, Permal. Permal gets it as far as the RPI line, played back across. Into the zone comes Sullivan this time. We make it off a deflection. That came off of Hampton and went just wide of the goal. Law once more, trying to get away from Hampton again. He hasn't had a great shift, nearly put the puck into his own net. And there gets lost on the play. It's kept in along the boards, however, by Permal, doing a great job to just keep the puck in the zone. And on a third effort, rings it deep and allows the Saints to change. Engineers pick it up in their own zone. We're 15-13 left in the third. Now an errant pass far side. Hampton chops at it. Working in front, a pad save. A loose puck in the circle. Who wants it? Liljegren overskated as he was tied up there by Laidley. They pair off in the near corner of the RPI zone. DeVito, the third man in, or fifth man in, if you will, picks the puck out of there. Took a hop off the linesman near side. And now it's picked up by McGovern. He'll skate right back into RPI territory. Stolen away by Liljegren. Trying to kick it to himself. Lost the puck to Horn, or make it to Hagen, rather. Hagen trying to get away from DeVito. DeVito plays it behind the goal for the defenseman, Hampton. And now it's going to be Orval to carry to center. Freshman Orval moves it in from Halmstad, Sweden. He gets crushed there by Glukowski. And the Engineers will elect to just chip it deep. Shots are 29-26 Engineers as the Saints flip it in the air to center ice. Right on to Prapavassis, who's backing up in his own zone. He'll play it softly up the near wall. Sweetman keeps it alive in the zone. Sweetman dangling in front, fed in front. And turning with it is Horn. Drop pass, Bayreuther. Shot coming, blocked by Schrader, and he is down. Schrader took that shot up high. He's back to his feet and hobbling off. That one caught him in the knee, it looks like, as he is slowly making his way back to the bench. The Engineers take over with the puck, and they'll gather here and reset, allowing for the Engineers to change. Shot in deep. It'll be played around behind by Bayreuther. Smolzinski. Smolzinski, long outlet pass, not looking for it was Thompson. This will be an easy icing call for the linesman. 13:38 left in the third, no score.
You had to give it up for Zach Schrader, who completely sold out in order to make that block. That's something that's been a touchstone for this RPI team this season, is blocking shots. But that one looked like it hit him in a pretty sensitive spot, and he's off to the locker room for some attention. He's already hobbled back there.
Played by Babella, lost it, trying to move to the front of the net. It'll be Smolzinski to carry to center. Takes a hit in front of his own bench, plays it in deep, as finishing his check that time was Miller. Slow to get up along the far boards is Gusevich for the Saints. Here is Tommy Grant for the Engineers. On for Babella. Crossing center ice, he'll move it into Saints territory. Takes a bump, and now we get a whistle and offside call, probably for the better, as who knows what was going on there.
I think RPI needs to settle themselves down on defense a little bit. They've looked a little bit sloppy in their own end. And Jason Kasdorf, usually you can depend on him to make the big saves, and he's been making saves, but aren't quite as crisp as we're used to seeing from him. So big opportunity for St. Lawrence if they can push this advantage that they've got right now.
Face off here, center ice. One by the Saints. Masella carrying through center, shoots it into the corner. And actually out of play, watch out up there. There's a fan sitting all by himself in the bottom of that row. It looks like he got a puck. But he's going to find a younger fan and hand it to him.
As is the heavily enforced requirement around here. So good for him. Faceoff coming up at neutral ice. 13:01 left in regulation, no score.
Draw to the engineers. It's Bradley shooting in from center off the glass. Picked up by Liljegren in the circle. He lost it as he was bumped there by Permal. Near side Law takes a look around, drops it back behind the goal, past Masella, and now Permal again. Permal has it poked away by Bourbonnais, but nobody home to pick up the pieces for RPI. It's put up the boards, hits the linesman, helped into the zone. Bradley chops it back to center, and now a chance to move in 2-on-2. Liljegren, wrist shot, save, rebound! Bourbonnais trying to find it. And that, again, his stick comes down near the glove of Hayton, and the Saints, very defensive of their goalie, as many teams are, but sometimes overly so.
Yeah, this is looks like it's overly so, because this was a situation where Riley Barbary is crashing to get that rebound, and what team isn't going to do that against?
The puck was actually still loose.
It was plenty loose, and Eric Sweetman really, I'll say he was lucky not to take a penalty there, but he's lucky he didn't do much more than he did.
Sweetman with the puck off the defensive zone, faceoff win, gets it to the RPI line. Moved in by Laidley, takes a shot, easy stop for Kasdorf. Almost no angle on that one, high in the air. Where will it come down? Right on the RPI side of center. We're going to get a hand pass called here against the Saints. And another stoppage in play. It's been a helter-skelter, a start to this third period.
Well, for RPI, at least the pressure is coming off a little bit on the other end. That's some good news. Let that defense get a little bit of rest and get your own licks in on one of the best goaltenders in the country instead of the other team. 12:10 left in regulation, RPI 0, St. Lawrence 0.
Faceoff here, near side of Hayton, won by the Saints. Glukowski off the boards to center, swatted at by Wilson, but carried on by McGovern. Into the RPI zone, McGovern stops along the near boards. Fed in front, trickling on goal. Kasdorf will cover with Hagen crashing.
Right idea for St. Lawrence, just wasn't executed perfectly. The puck ended up really not being much of a danger for Jason Kasdorf, who makes his 26th save of the evening to go up against the 30 on the other end of the field house by Kyle Hayden.
Face off to the left of Kasdorf on a Winnipeg, Manitoba. Picked up by Prapovesis, and now Wood off the boards to center. Knocked down by Kasevich. He'll work it up the wall, broken up by Wood. He gets hit hard up high, although it's not hard to get to his upper body area, shoulders and head. Here's Bayreuther at the point, fed towards goal, bouncing puck, skips by. Kasdorf blockered it to the corner to make sure. Marnell and Bradley go into the backboards. Babella gets a hit. Pinching in over there is Gusevich. Babella runs into Gusevich hard. As Marnell tries to dig it out of there, Bradley's with him. Loose behind the cage, Prapovesis pokes it to the near wall, pinching in Bayreuther. He'll work it back down low, hits the base of the net. Saints want to change, engineers have a chance to move it out to center. Lobbed ahead, looking for Miller. Miller wasn't looking for the pass, and will be picked up by Pritchard behind his own net. He gets hit by a couple engineers, but the Saints have the puck, and they're skating out to center. Gavin Bayreuther on the move, backhand pass far side into the zone. Smolzinski to the slot, wrist shot coming, that one goes wide. It's poked away by DeVito. Pritchard carrying back to the point. Rister coming. Saved by Kasdorf. Kept it against that chest protector and holds on.
Zach Schrader already back on the RPI bench after initially heading off to get some medical attention for the puck that he took. Looked like he took it in the knee. He's back on the bench. I don't know if we've seen him on the ice since then, but he's at least back with his teammates. So a good sign if you're an RPI fan.
Draw here in the RPI zone. Approaching the halfway mark of the third. Pormel a shot. Stick saved by Kasdorf to the corner. Law. Stick handling. Little backhand saucer pass. Masella. His shot is turned away by Kasdorf as well. High in the air up the far side boards. Liljegren trying to jump on it. Masella just a little bit of a step on him. Beat him to it, but It's picked off behind the goal and out of the near corner. Orval, he's tackled by Permal. Played behind. Poke free to the point. Marnell on further. Into the zone come the Saints as Alexander Dahl just jumps it in, dumps it in. And now Wilson for RPI. Jared Wilson, 4 goals, 3 assists on the season. The sophomore from Calgary, Alberta, shoots it deep. He'll go off with a change. Mulczynski, or make it Sweetman rather, trying to clear it out far side. Engineers have a skate against the boards. That was Orval. Finally, it leaves the zone. Schrader back out there. Had a poke at that one, but it's Gukowski carrying on. Avoids a check, and the Saints are offside. He had to step around the engineer that was flying at him, and luckily for Bradley, the Saints were offside there because it forced Bradley into a way out of position spot there on the ice.
That was great back checking by Zach Schrader to basically help out his captain and help force St. Lawrence into an offside position.
Draw here just outside the RPI zone. Pritchard chopping at it, works it below the goal line. Chris Bradley, the first one to it for RPI. Back behind for Tommy Grant. So some mismatching of defensive pairings here for RPI. Grant half fan on the pass, but Melanson came to pick it up for him. Bradley into the zone, kind of a 3-on-2 here. And his shot is stick to the glass behind Hayton. Schrader picks it up in the corner now. Played it behind for Melanson. One time pass far side, not sure exactly who he was looking for. And now a chance to break for the Saints into the zone. Laidley in, shot, crossbar and out. And that'll leave the ice surface.
Well, that's as close as either of these teams are getting is to put it off the bars. There have been a grand total of 61 shots in this game. None of them have hit the twine. 31 saves for Hayton, 30 for Jason Kasdorf. Nothing between these two teams with 9:13 left in regulation. And the faceoff coming up to the right of Kasdorf.
Draw here. It'll be Babella against McGovern. A couple of seniors draw it up, and McGovern wins that too strongly between his two defensemen all the way out of the zone. And it's going to be Bayreuther to pick it up in his own end. Played near side for Laidley. He couldn't control. This will be icing on the Saints, and we'll have a stoppage in play.
And this is where the faceoffs have got to be a turnaround for RPI. This is a kind of an unforced error on the Saints. So an attacking zone faceoff for the Engineers. Those are almost gimmies. You win those, you get a free opportunity to take a shot in a game like this. Been saying it all period. Just take shots, see what happens.
Face off here, Babella trying to find it. Work back to the point for Wilson. Babella knocked it down along the wall. Cleared by Bayreuther. Bouncing puck in the Engineer's end. Pravovesis over to pick it up. Played it back for Wilson. Up the wall, tapped into the zone by Nanny. Bayreuther the first one to it. He's met by Miller in the backboard. Babella digs for it as well. Played to the far wall. Tied up there was Hagen. McGovern trying to carry it out to center. He's hog-tied by Babella. Loose puck. Saints trying to make a change. Moved in near side. Shot by Miller. Glove saved by Hayton. And again, he's seeing the puck well. And when either of these goalies at this point see a puck, they're more than likely going to keep it out.
I think that was intended to be a tip. That was going wide, but that's one of the reasons why if you're a netminder, you're going to glove pucks down that are going wide. It was intended to go to Nanny on the far side to tip in. So even if it's anywhere near you, you're just going to glove it down.
Puck plate behind the goal. Here's Mosella. Hit thrown by DeVito. Liljegren gets shoved against the glass. And now Marnell on for Mosella. Chance for the Saints to break in. Odd man rush style, though it's only a 4-on-3, and a bad pass sends Liljegren back the other way for RPI. Liljegren shielding the puck away from his man, walking right in. Shot pad save. Rebound loose in front. And it's cleared to the far side circle. Horn takes a whack at it. Still can't find it. Played to center. Good read there by Mears Moore to break things up at center. Missing on the hit was Liljegren, but it's Hampton to pick it up. Saints want to change anyway. Long outlet pass, too far for Orval. Icing on the Engineers. And we will have a whistle. It probably already went. 7:44 to go, third period. No score, RPI and St. Lawrence.
I'm just going the other way now. It's an unforced error on RPI. That was not a high percentage pass for the Engineers to try to connect on. So now they have to defend the face-off in their own zone with 7:44 left in the period.
Draw here, poke back towards the point. There's a loose stick on the ice. Played by Ward off the boards. Smolzinski's taken over by Hampton. Played behind for Moore. Mears Moore down the middle for Liljegren. Victor Liljegren crossing center, trying to get it deep. Didn't do so. Glukowski feeds it far side for Smolzinski. Saints not quick to jump on the opportunity with the engineers changing. RPI fires it back to center. There are two Saints way offside. And now they'll jump back onside. Not in time. That'll draw a whistle.
Yeah, they were kind of like staring at the puck. And it's kind of a thing where it's like, you might want to get yourself back to the blue line. That's the way this game is played. But yeah. They didn't. So the faceoff just outside the RPI end.
Draw coming up. Just outside the RPI zone. Now a race for the puck as it was Grant going into it with Ward. And the engineers are finally able to work it out far side. Or make it to Dahl, rather. Puck just trickling wide of the RPI cage. Here's Long. Stick handling to the middle of the ice. Wilson has his man all wrapped up, and now Schrader comes away with it. Chipped out to center into Saints territory. Gusevich has it. Playing it up the boards. Skips right by Schrader. He would have had a chance to move in on goal. Marnell back to RPI territory, stops at the far point, saucer pass near side, Bayreuther. Bayreuther's tied up and poked away. Trying to jump on this one is Bourbonnais. He gets a little bit of a whack there from Masella, who wants a slashing call. So does Hayden, not going to get it. And in turn, thought they should have got an icing, they don't. 6.5 to go in the third period. No score, RPI. And the Saints, the skating Saints of St. Lawrence. Here is Bubella. Couldn't get it to the line. Played back to RPI territory. Who wants it? Melanson kind of gave up on the play, as did Bradley. Now they're going to have to fight to win it back. Lately in front. Jam try at the side of the cage. Hagen couldn't catch it cleanly. Behind the goal now it's Hagen. Centering pass. Put Prepovesis in the right spot at the right time. Able to clear to center. And Glukowski fires it right back in for the Saints. Jake Wood jumps on a loose puck and he overskated. McGovern had it knocked off his stick. Somebody settled this thing down. Nope, fired in by Hagen. Skips over Kasdorf's stick. Bubella back behind the goal, trying to find some settle to this game. This is now Prapovesis to center, backhand feed near side. Bubella kicks it to himself into the slot, top of the circle. And that shot up into the netting came off the defenseman's stick. We'll have a faceoff in the St. Lawrence zone.
Rough night for the Engineer women. They are taking on Clarkson up in the North Country, and with 4:37 left in that game, the Golden Knights have taken an 8-1 lead over RPI. So now like a 9-1 lead.
Saratil is going in. It's the third goalie used for RPI tonight. I think Clarkson was the last team to put a 10 spot on the RPI women a couple of years ago. It looks like it may be happening again. Here's an icing against the Saints. Tough spot, yeah.
Certainly more scoring in that game than there has been here this evening. That's absolutely true. Yes, RPI lost to Clarkson 10-0 at Chiel on December 2nd, 2011. That was the last time the Engineers allowed 10 goals in a game.
Feels like just yesterday. 5:18 to go in this one. We do not have a goal. As the Saints look to break out to center, Horn near side for Marnell. Marnell to the circle, fed across, one-timer, they score, what a play. Tommy Thompson puts the Saints on the board.
That's the way it was going to happen. Get the netminder looking one way, get the puck moving the other. Had a wide open net to shoot on, you can't fault Jason Kasdorf on that one. St. Lawrence executed nicely there. Tommy Thompson with his sixth goal of the season for St. Lawrence. With 5:07 left in the game, we have a goal. It is 1-0 St. Lawrence.
So Tommy Thompson picks up goal number 6 on the year. It was a one-timer in the slot and a no-doubter there. Not much Kasdorf could do about it. Engineers get it deep. Played around to the far side. And into the far circle. Can't quite clear the zone. Now they do. Permal leading the rush from his defensive spot. Far side, Smolzinski. Top of the circle, near side Ward, one-timer. That one was up on edge, and he fired it way over the top of the net. Here's Masella along the wall to the slot now. Smolzinski trying to feed it near side for Ward. A second effort worked all the way down low. Pritchard. Hand off there. Around the net goes Sweetman. All the way to the near point is Sweetman. Nearly ran into his own man. That was Glukowski, who works it down low. Saints doing a good job cycling the puck here. Sweetman's shot was blocked by Nanny. Couldn't find it. Glukowski will just filter it right back down low. So here's Bradley skating away from danger. Saints want to get a change. Bradley from center ice fires it in. Gloved by Hayton. He'll leave it at the side for Sweetman. Out ahead of the play, Marnell. Chased by Grant. Marnell behind the goal. Around to the near side corner for Law. Law to the point. Bayreuther's shot. That hits traffic in front. Wood, far side corner. Around to the near side for Wilson. Wilson has a man breaking far side. Half fanned on the pass. Loose at center. Runs into Dahl and now carried in by Miller. Drop pass, one-timer on the try by Wood. He caught it cleanly, but it was blocked by the defense. Now a race for the puck. Dahl, one-on-one with Wilson. A tight angle shot and a shoulder save by Kasdorf. Puck into the netting, and we have a stoppage. 3:20 to play, and the Saints have a 1-0 lead here late in the third.
And scoring the goal at 14:53 of the third period. Neiman Strand's goal makes a 1-0 St. Lawrence. Tommy Thompson, his sixth goal of the season, the lone assist going to sophomore Mike Marnell.
Face off to the right of Kasdorf. Shots are 34-31 Engineers. But just the one has gotten by Kasdorf. That's been it so far. Kept in near side by Masella. He's wrapped up with Orval. DeVito trying to dig it out of there. Finally comes free to Bradley. Works it far side for Mike Prapovesis. Prapovesis. Stick handling free as a man in front of him, McGovern, drops it back for Bradley. Down the middle of the ice, Orval gets run into by DeVito. Puck goes in wide of Hayton. He'll leave it there. Permal, near side for Masella. It's been a while since the Engineers have generated a true scoring chance in this game, and they'll need to do so with 2:43 left as the Saints get a fresh set of skaters out there. Chris Bradley from behind his own goal. Over to Prapovesis, drop it back. Bradley, near side, Prapovesis, on further for Schrader. Into the zone all by himself, takes a hit from Glukowski, gets it deep. It'll be played by Sweetman. Far side up the boards, Marnell. On for Horn, he'll pull it back down low. Centering pass, one-timer, they score again. And it's Thompson again. On a feed from Horn, and it's 2-0 Saints.
That's some lackadaisical defense there by the Engineers, and St. Lawrence very keen to capitalize on that one. Just a nice feed from behind the net and a one-timer. That's another good way to get one past, as Kyle Hayton kind of does a little mock bow down to Tommy Thompson there. A really nice one-timer by the Saints senior. His second goal of the night, his second goal in just a couple of minutes.
That one beat Kasdorf short side inside the left post.
Just an all-around great goal by Thompson to make this a 2-0 game and pretty much put a seal on this one for St. Lawrence.
Nanny into the zone. Off goes Kasdorf with 2:09 to go. You are listening to RPI Hockey 91.5 FM, WRPI Troy. Here's Miller. A wrister over the top. Loose to the side of the cage, and Bayreuther had a whack at it. He'll try and clear it out now. And now a chance here with an empty net. Loose puck, playing goalie is Bradley, and it's buried for the empty net goal. It's going to be Jacob Pritchard, and just like that, it's 3-0 with a minute 50 left.
Well, the final score is going to say 3-0, or maybe it won't. We still have a minute 50 left, but you know, it's not going to be very indicative of the way this game went. St. Lawrence really just executing very well late in this game, especially, but the third period in general has been dominated by St. Lawrence. They've done a great job of going out there and wanting to get these pucks, taking good shots, making Kasdorf a little bit uneasy where he is in his net. And they're going to come away with two very well-earned points here this evening.
Back to the attack of the Engineers. Puck along the far wall. And now all the way down the ice. This will be icing on the Saints. No, it won't. They wave it off. Back out to center it goes. Masella cross ice there for Permal. Permal scooping it along. Fans here almost running out of the building for some reason. This is picked up at the point by Permal. Slap shot coming, saved by Kasdorf, and he'll hold on to it there.
Recapping on St. Lawrence's second goal, an even strength goal at 17:44 of the third period, scored by Tommy Thompson, his seventh of the season, second of the night. Assist goes to Christian Horn, who also had an assist added on the first goal. So two assists for Horn, two goals for Thompson, and the goal on the empty netter is for Jacob Pritchard, his third of the season, and the assists are to Smolchinski and Bayreuther at 18:10 of the third period.
Engineers have the puck in the neutral zone. It's Liljegren up the boards for Orval. Orval spins back towards the point, flips it near side, a little bit of room for more, a drive, hit a shin pad. Liljegren tried to jam it in front, clearing effort, and they'll move it towards the line, kept in by Mears Moore. Down low for Liljegren. A minute to go in the third, 3-0 Saints. All of a sudden, as it's Glukowski trying to clear it out far side, chipped out to center, and Moore will claim it there. Shots are now even at 34. It's just how the Saints got even that was the issue in this game.
Yeah, the frustration starting to mount for RPI is they've now gone over six full periods without scoring a goal. If you go back to the last tally that they had against Brown, which was about halfway through the third period last Friday, they weren't able to get one in against Yale, and they're 40 seconds away from going without getting one in against St. Lawrence either.
Puck cleared. That was another block, and Melanson now slow to get up. Race for the puck near side, backhanded all the way down the ice. Stopped there by Bradley. So Melanson blocks the shot, as Schrader did earlier. This is going to be a beat-up RPI team, and hopefully an angry one, as they head to the locker room in just a few seconds. 13 to go. All the way down, this should be icing on the Saints, and we'll get a stoppage here with 9.2 left. The engineers...
That's probably the last thing RPI wanted to see. Down 3-0. It's a good sign that you guys are still willing to go down and block shots in a game where you don't have any prayer coming back, but see Melanson trying to hobble off there. He wasn't putting much weight on his right knee. And he ended up heading back towards the locker room. St. Lawrence is calling timeout for some reason.
Wow.
That's not a way to win friends around here. Up 3-0 and calling timeout with 9.2 seconds left. That's... One wonders what them... They're trying to make sure that their guys are going to get the shutout for Hayton. That's about it, but...
Yeah, they have one.
You can't take it with you.
You're right. I don't have a problem with it as much. 9.2 left. Engineers, only time they've been shut out in this building this year. They also gave up zero goals themselves against Harvard. All the other shutouts have come on the road against them. Bradley has shot over the top of the net with 3 seconds. Mosella far side avoids a hit from Gillespie. And that will do it here for the night before freakout. The Engineers fall here to the Saints 3-0. And they'll look to rebound tomorrow against another hot team in the Clarkson Golden Knights.
Yeah, this was not the kind of performance that RPI needed coming out of last weekend. They were pretty much outclassed by Yale, but they had an opportunity to come back here and shake it off. They didn't have a bad first couple of periods, but I think they lacked a little bit of that killer instinct that they needed in the third period. And it was always going to be difficult getting one past Hayden. That was the struggle. But they kind of got out of their lane a little bit. They weren't playing the type of defensive hockey that has given them success this season. And St. Lawrence, it took them a little bit to get to the point where they were going to put one in, but I think realistically for the 10 minutes or so before Tommy Thompson finally broke one onto the board, you kind of felt it was coming. It was on its way. The Saints were having their way in the faceoff circle with possession. They were getting good shots. They were getting good looks. And you add all of that up in a scoreless game, and it's going to turn into good things for your side. And that's exactly what happened for St. Lawrence here tonight. They got the first goal. That was really all they needed. After that, the other two goals were pretty much icing on the cake, especially the second one. The third one was very superfluous. You look at this one, you see a 3-0 loss. It's probably closer to a 1-0 loss for RPI the way this one played out, but they've got a little bit less than 24 hours to get themselves up, dust themselves off, and really prepare for what's going to be a huge game that the entire season's going to turn on now for RPI, because after tomorrow, their next two games are on the road against Harvard, who's been very strong lately. A Dartmouth team that suddenly looks like they might be a little bit shaky defensively, but they're certainly no slouch.
They're one of the top four teams in the second half.
They have beaten RPI in this building, too, which is only the second time this year that RPI has lost a league game here.
Yep.
And then you've got Quinnipiac at home. So those three games, there's no gimmies there at all. Tomorrow night's not a gimme, but, boy, it's going to be super important if RPI is going to be contending for that bye at this point, because I haven't seen the final score of the Harvard game, but they were winning in that one. Yale has now defeated Dartmouth, so that leapfrogs Yale over RPI. They're now have fallen into fourth tonight. It's time to staunch the bleeding. Two losses in a row with some tough ones coming up on the road. Tomorrow's probably as big of a must-win as the Engineers have had all year.
Absolutely, and past freakouts, Tom, have been Slump Busters. I can't remember exactly the year. I think it was back in the 90s, maybe even earlier. The Engineers took like something like an 8 or 10 game winless streak into the freakout and won. It's been a magical game for a number of reasons. We'll touch more on that tomorrow. Tom and I will.
Well, it was this, against this very same Clarkson team,
right,
in 2002,
right?
That
Mark Cabosi.
RPI kind of limped into that game. They were struggling all year. I think they were in last place in January that year. They win freakout. They not only win freakout, they do it in sublime
They're
fashion.
They're down 3-0 with 13 left. Yeah.
They win 4-3 in overtime on a goal by, I believe it was Carson Butterwick in overtime. But
yep, it was Butterwick.
Two goals,
yeah,
by Cabosi to help bring them back. Saw a little bit of that last week when we had two goals by Liljegren,
yep,
to bring RPI back from 3-0 against Brown. But this may be a fulcrum on which the entire season will turn. If they don't get a good result tomorrow, things could go sour in a big hurry for RPI. And it looks like St. Lawrence is back. So ECAC beware.
Running down the scoring in this game, Tom will come up with his offensive and defensive engineers of the game. First goal was scored by Tommy Thompson, his sixth of the year, from Mike Marnell and Christian Horn at 14:53 of the third period, after two scoreless frames, mind you. And then it was Thompson again, his seventh, from Horn and Marnell again at 17:44. An empty net goal was scored by Jacob Pritchard, his third of the season, from Drew Smolzinski and Gavin Bayreuther. That comes at 18:10. Of the third. Shots were 34 apiece. If you can do the math, that's 34 stops for Kyle Hayton, 31 for Jason Kasdorf.
Well, my offensive engineer of the game, I'm going to have kind of a honorable mention followed by a winner, and then for defense, I've got an honorable mention with two winners.
Okay.
So lots of love to go around, even though this is a game RPI did not win or score a goal in. Offensively, my honorable mention is for Lou Nanny. He scores goals by being in the right place at the right time. And he did that quite a bit tonight. He just wasn't able to find a way to put one past Kyle Hayton. He's a guy who's going to score on redirections. He's right in front of the net for rebounds, for tip-ins, just for tipping the puck past the netminder. That's what he does well. He did it tonight, just wasn't able to finally put one to the back of the cage. And he's been real strong for that lately for the Engineers. He was a big part of the comeback against Brown. The last couple of weeks, he's been real strong on the score sheet. Just wasn't his night to put one through. But I really like the way Drew Melanson hustled tonight. He had two kind of, I'd say the best opportunities that the Engineers had to score tonight were off the stick of Drew Melanson. He had one coming in from Kyle Hayton's right that took the puck to the net and wasn't able to jam it home. And then another opportunity coming right out of the penalty box at a 3-on-1 that he probably should have chosen to pass it against a netminder of the caliber of Kyle Hayton on a 3-on-1 chance, but still took his shot anyway and was working hard at trying to get the rebound as well afterwards. Ended up drawing a penalty for St. Lawrence that created RPI's only power play chance of the evening. So Drew Melanson, my RPI offensive engineer of the game. Defensively, I think there's a strong case to be made for Jason Kasdorf's play tonight. He was outstanding. He made the first 30 saves of the game. He wasn't able to make 31 or 32, unfortunately, for the Engineers. But another strong outing in net for the guy that gives RPI the opportunity to win pretty much any game that they're in when he's playing. But I want to point out two guys who really have bought into RPI's philosophy of stopping shots. They both ended up hobbling off the ice. We saw Zach Schrader come back after his blocked shot. Drew Melanson did not, but there wasn't really enough time for him to come back since it was in the waning moments of the game. But just the willingness of RPI forwards even to kind of to sell out the body in order to stop shots, especially with Melanson's, which was in the final minute. And if you're an RPI fan, you certainly hope that he'll be okay in time for tomorrow, because he was one of the more effective attackers tonight. Just the willingness to put your body at risk to stop shots, even in a hopeless situation, that underscores the defensive attitude and strategies of this team. So my co-defensive players tonight for the Engineers, Zach Schrader and Drew Melanson.
Well, we are just about ready to wrap things up and get out of here for this evening. We want to remind you that our next WRPI sports broadcast will be tomorrow night from the Houston Fieldhouse as the RPI engineers take on the Clarkson Golden Knights in an ECAC hockey contest that is also the 39th annual Big Red Freakout. Puck drop for that game should be at about 7 o'clock, so our on-air time will be roughly 6:45 p.m. Kurt Stutt and Ed Degarian on the call for you tomorrow night. We also would like to thank DJ Scooter back at the station for getting us on the air and keeping us there this evening. The Sounds of Now will be following this broadcast. We also want to thank the Rensselaer Union. They provide the funding for WRPI and all the club-related activity in the Institute, including WRPI's coverage of RPI hockey, football, and baseball. Just a reminder, WRPI is on the World Wide Web. Point your browser to WRPI.org, and you can pick up WRPI's broadcast 24 hours a day and 7 days a week. As long as WRPI is broadcasting, that broadcast is provided for free on our internet feed. Once again, that is WRPI.org. So, for Perilous Garris, my name is Tom Reel. Your final score from Houston Fieldhouse this evening, St. Lawrence defeats the Engineers by a score of 3-0. You've been listening to live coverage of Engineers Hockey on 91.5 FM, WRPI Troy.